that we are hearing today is the state of Ohio versus DeJuwann Woods. The state has waived oral argument today, so you will have 15 minutes to present your argument. The arguments are being recorded, so please keep your voice up and remain behind the podium. You should not use the names of children, minors, and victims during your argument, and you can refer to them by initials or terms like the child, should that be appropriate. And the judges, of course, have read your briefs and are ready to proceed when you are.
Thank you. Good morning, Your Honors. May it please the court. I'm here on behalf of DeJuwann Woods this morning, essentially challenging the sentence that was imposed in this case. It's an 18-month prison term for a violation of a community control sanction. The argument laid out in the brief goes over the case law that's applicable here as well as the statute. And I know that the state in their response indicated that the statute did change just before the plea in this case and the sentencing in this case. So under the old statute, under 2929.19b4, the court was required to state a specific prison term that would be imposed upon a violation. The only change now is that the court has to indicate the range from which the prison term can be imposed, and that's obviously a range under 2929.14. This case was dealing with a felony of the fourth degree, so the range was 6 to 18 months in monthly increments. When we look, though, through the transcripts, and I would invite the court to review it again, and I know you've reviewed it today, you won't find the word violate in those transcripts. The sentencing hearing was very short. It's only 18 pages long, and the part where the imposition of community control is placed on the defendant in this case, there is absolutely no mention of what would happen if there's a violation of community control. Specifically, when you're looking at page 14, that's where the interaction is with the court and the defendant. It says, so it's the state sentence that, I'm sorry, it's the sentence of the court that I will place you on 2 years of community control. I, however, will order as a condition of that community control that you are to serve 180 days in the Summit County Jail. I would hold an 18-month prison sentence in reserve. You're to report to the jail by 4 p.m., and then I will indicate I would consider not making you serve the entire 180 days if the court feels you're deserving of some sort of early release. That's the interaction that's had with the defendant in this case. There's nothing within the interaction that says, if you violate the terms of this sentence, I will impose a prison term in the range. As I indicated, the court has a statement that says I would hold an 18-month prison sentence in reserve, but what does that actually mean? So the statute says under 2929.19b4 that the court shall notify the offender if the conditions of the sanction are violated, that they may impose a longer sanction, a more restrictive sanction, or impose a prison term and shall state the range. I don't see that here, and as I've indicated, there's nothing within the actual sentencing hearing where you're gonna find the word violate, where the appellant in this case was notified that that would be the outcome of a violation. Some of the case law that I cited within the brief goes through, I understand the prior section where it was the specific term, looking at the McWilliams case, all of those cases that I cited within my brief, I think you could still apply the logic of the law there to what the argument is. Because in those cases, there was either a missing specific prison term at the sentencing hearing, or there was the specific prison term missing from the journal entry following the sentencing hearing. Sometimes it was one, sometimes it was both. And under all of the circumstances, the courts of appeals in this district and in the 8th district said, vacate the sentence and remand it back to the trial court. So even if we're looking at the range, which I don't see that here, I know that there's that statement that it says I would hold 18 months in reserve. 18 months in reserve is not a range, but even if it is, we still don't have anything in the subsequent journal entry that says what would be imposed upon a violation. When you look at the judgment entry, it actually says as a part of this sentence in this case, violation of any sentence imposed may lead to more restrictive sanctions for the defendant, up to and including a prison term. But what term is that? So I think that the trial court failed not only during the sentencing hearing to comply with 2929.19b4, but also failing to put the specific range that could be imposed upon a violation in the sentencing entry. logic of the case law that I cited within the brief, we still don't have one or the other. I think we don't have both, but even if we have one, it's still not in the entry, and I think the only remedy is for this court to vacate the sentence and send it back to the trial court. So that's what we're asking this court to do in this case today.
Okay, if my colleagues don't have any questions. Okay, thank you very much for your argument, and we will take the matter under advisement, issue a decision in due course. The court, of course, will mail a copy of the decision to you on the day it is released, and the opinions will also be posted on the Ohio Supreme Court website. And at this time, we will adjourn and reconvene.
Judge Sutton,
yeah.
I just thought of one.
Oh, okay. Sure.
I'm so sorry.
That's okay.
But I was just thinking, what would the court, can you give me any other interpretation for what the court meant by 18 months in days?
I mean, from my position, just in knowing and practicing in that court, my understanding is that she was holding that over his head. So if he violated, she could send him to prison for up to the maximum amount of time. But then when you read the rest of the interactions, and that's where I noted the conversation she had about not wanting him to even serve the entire residential sanction on community control, the 180 days, there was a comment where she talked to him about that specifically, saying, I don't think you should have to serve this whole time. I'm not making any promises, but essentially I would entertain your early release on that sanction. So I think when you read it collectively as a whole, that even though she said I would hold 18 months in reserve, I don't think it was her intent to actually impose a full 180 days on the community control side of it. So it's hard to say definitively what that meant, but obviously he was sentenced to 18 months. So
thank you very much. The court will now adjourn and reconvene shortly to hear our next case, the State of Ohio versus